In the third standard mathematics book, that is grade variation. Everything is in science, but you have to look for that specific science that deals with that, especially to that grade which deals with this particular thing. So it is known as proper approach of grade and discipline. Like when they told that, somebody told, if something is done there, do you just mean that those things are against nature or physics? Then I told that they are not against nature, they are special rules of nature. The exploitation of nature is done by only human beings. All energy and power resources are special rules or exemptions of nature. As are equally regulations and exemptions. We have seen that there is electricity and it will charge our body. That is a rule. And if a person wears rubber gloves, rubber does not conduct electricity, so the person will not be harmed. That is not against the rule of electricity, but that is a special rule of non-conductivity, whereby the person takes the charge of the charge, controls it, and does the work properly. So this is how we can understand. No rule that is as per philosophy, religion, spiritualism that is meant for the society, no rule is against nature. They are special provisions of nature, exemptions of nature, which are incorporated within the nucleus of the nature itself. It is paranatural things are not anti-natural. Lot of these artificial inventions are clearly this biodegradation, exploitation, these things are anti-natural. The science which is claiming to preserve nature, these things are indulging in lot of anti things. Para is entirely different from anti. So these type of forces are there. The pervasion or permeation is vyapti, yugavat sannidhi, simultaneously being present in various things. And the sixth thing is possession, niyantrana. A person having distant possession is there. Inhibited possession is also there. Possession is of four types. There is what we call Archavatara Avesha, Archa Samadhi Ullangana, Bhagavata Avesha. We used to read it in scriptures. And hagiographic treatises that God permeated inside some specially gifted personality and revealed lot of truths. That is known as a divine possession. That may be transient, occasional or permanent. And second thing is celestial possession, in which devatas they used to occupy. Then demonic possession, wherein by lot of deities, goblins and other structures they used to occupy. Then devilish possession of paishashas and other things. That means we are seeing lot of fictions and lot of people are behaving worse than deities possession with normal human possession itself. So he used to experience these things better than my experience. So this is known as possession. Then there is revelation. Apart from possession, revelation. Yes, the Divya Prabandha is a revelation. Each and every people, each and every religious person or community, they are allowed to say that their scriptures are revelations and the revelators or the revealers are the authenticated prophets or the lineage of that, and anybody contradicting that thing is not authenticated, and this is the last of the lineage and nobody is going to come further to change all of this thing. It has become the total dogmatic strand of each and every religious stipulation or narrow-mindedness. It has become that. So revelation is also there. Apart from possession, for a purpose, possession for a long-term benefit or mass that gives some sort of benefit to the society is known as revelation of ideas, either in the form of scriptures or in the form of spiritual messages. These things are known as various other things. And also in mani mantra, we used to have manis, lot of the gems are there. According to our gems, they are just decorative, they are just very expensive, they are looking royal, and that show the status of our richness, apart from which they have lot of other healing qualities and mind setup qualities and lot of other things. Lot of lights are being thrown by lot of people, that is in usage. That is always study. And the study of mantra is very much important. That is known as photosynthesis. That type of things that is having a highly sophisticated order, that is order of ad infinitum and ultimatum, that which is having the ultimate sophisticated order beyond which cannot create anything, that is known as mantra. Mantra is the utmost saturated point of perfection beyond which you cannot commit anything to that. The second thing is that order or means of repetition that gains power. Number three, a person with proper regulatory principles, adoption and loyalty towards those things by belief and sincere execution, he becomes the qualified tool for exhibiting that power. Number one, first is the inherent power of the sophisticated order of mantras. Second is the power due to the repetitive recitation or ritualization. Third is the power of purity that is there within the reciter or the ritualizer or the person who corresponds with us by means of his austerity and spiritual practice and sincerity and belief. So there are three powers united to give the portions of the mantra has to be efficacious really for all mankind's benefit and success and happiness. That is the Mani mantra. Then Prana Pratishtha, they have been telling Prana Pratishtha. What is Prana Pratishtha? What is Prana? Niyate anena iti prana. Prakarshena niyate anena iti prana. The force, the basic immanent force that leads everything, that is known as prana. That is immanent in everybody, even this as prana. But what is the difference between your prana and this prana? This prana is subjective prana and it is a receptive prana, receptive consciousness. Now the global consciousness project, they have revealed that each and every project or product is the output of consciousness. There is consciousness in each and everything. In higher people like human beings, the consciousness is mature. We are seeing lack of people in human beings worse than trees. Why can't that be an assumption? Or a contemplative study of a permutation possibility where trees are more intellectual than human beings, which may be available in exobiotic studies, available in some other planets or something else. So, like this, even in the infra species, even in the insentient beings, that is prana. But the prana that requires a potential, the potential, and also some compatibility. Somebody told them, why can't you offer this beef to God? God resides everywhere. Why can't you offer this? Then we told that. Very simple. We can offer to God because God resides in meat, and while he is consuming the whole world at a time of dissolution, he is not avoiding this non-vegetarian creatures. All species are swallowed at the time of cosmic dissolution. You can give this thing as an offering to God, and God can also instill his blessings. But it is not a good conductor compatible to divine charge and its transmission. You can give, like I told, four conductors, bad conductors, semiconductors, conductors, hyperconductors. We used to study in the conductor study in physics. Likewise, that can be offered to God, but he wants to give his message to us. That is not a good transmitter, that is not a good conductor. So we cannot do that. So likewise, this type of understanding the basic principles that removes a lot of hurdles in spiritual realization. So here, this paranormalism in understanding about the mantras is very much important, because in upasana, in japa, in tapa, in havana, in pujana, in mandira, in shraddha, in upanayana and other samskaras, everywhere we are glorified with mantras. We are given, we have been given a lot of mantras. So unless we understand the phonosynthesis, like the work of photons, it is the work of phonons. By means of proper order I have told, and also by repetitive and analytical scrutiny, and also by the person's blemishless loyalty and sincerity in practice, mantras are really very beneficial. So each and everything is having its own life prana, and the prana can be induced only by special forces. We cannot do it with ordinary forces. We can do it with a lot of forces. The special thing, what is a mantra? Somebody told, how can you very simply put Vedas? I told that it is the most sophisticated information and communication technology. We cannot understand about the celestials or the forces behind the nature. We cannot understand the God who is behind the deities and forces. Information about those things is given only by these Vedas. Second thing is communication. Namaste Vayu, O wind, I worship. Nate Vishnu Jayamano Najato Deva Mahina Paramanta Mata. Oh Vishnu, you are very great and nobody is equal to you. Agne Naya Supataraye. Hey Agni, please lead me in your noble path. So it is a communication technology. Vedas are information technology about the unseen or invisible forces of nature, celestial forces behind nature, the divine forces behind the celestials. And also it provides you the proper way of communication. That is the greatness. That is known as Prana Pratishtha. If you do that prana pratishtha, immediately the already existing consciousness is induced. As it is induced, for example, somebody asked why you are doing samprokshana and we are doing a lot of other things. Then immediately I told, there need not be a switch or regulator for the cosmic electricity or magnetism. Whenever you tap and pull it for your use, that limited thing, you are taking a part of affinity from that infinity for your application, that is a switch to on, to off and to regulate. That does not mean that the whole electric system can be just regulated like that. Likewise, even if you store that energy by means of a practice on agamas, shraddha, bhakti, vishwasa, etc., then that requires a proper process of installation, then rejuvenation, recycling, all these processes are required for the stored energy.